The warning 911 assist fault in a fault vehicle may be accompanied by several other problems, and this makes it much easier to locate the actual culprit. First of all, you may see this 911 assist fault message and your radio will not be working, or the phone will not be paired. In this case, the problem is with the head unit system, but most likely with the sync control system. Later in this video, I will give you a simple idea on how to reset it. If you see the 911 assist fault and see the airbag warning light, the problem is with the airbag module in the first place. The 911 assist feature is actually connected to the SRS module, and when several airbags are deployed, 911 assist will automatically call emergency services to the location of the accident. So if the 911 assist doesn't get data from the airbag module, you will see the 911 fault message and also the airbag light. Sometimes this may be a problem with a connector, but most likely the issue is in the restraint system, and it requires professional inspection and repair only. If you don't see the airbag light, this 911 assist fault is most likely about the sync system, which also communicates with the SOS system and will trigger the warning once something is wrong. The first thing is to notice if the problem is persistent. If the message is gone after you turn the car off and then on, it's just a glitch and there is nothing to worry about, at least till it reappears. If the problem is constant, you need to try to reset the sync. For this, unpair any connected phones that you have through the sync screen, just delete them from the memory. Then turn off the ignition, locate the sync fuse in the interior fuse box and take it out. Then turn the ignition on for 30 seconds or so, turn it off again and put the fuse back. Alternatively, if you don't want to mess around with fuses, you may disconnect the 12-volt battery for 5 or 7 minutes and get the same result. If this fixes your issue, this is a software glitch. If not, you most likely have a faulty sync control module or issues with the connector. In this case, I would recommend finding a good independent mechanic specialized in Ford vehicles and asking them to inspect the wiring and connectors. Dealerships will insist on installing the new module, which may cost $400 to $1,500 depending on the model year of your car, but it's not always the culprit. You need a good inspection first before you spend that much money on repairs.